Hi, I'm Niall Heaney from Gulfstream Boat Sales. This is a 2010 Williams 325 Turbojet Jet Tender. It is fitted with a Weber 750cc 98 horsepower Jetdrive engine. It has currently 57 hours on the clock. It's being sold complete with a Williams tonneau cover and the trailer that you see it sitting on. This is just a little walk around tour. I'm going to show you the condition that the boat's in. We're going to show you the features inside it and hopefully just help you to figure out whether this might be the right boat for you. These little Williams jet tenders are a fabulous product. They're built in England. They have a brilliant name and they're a very high-end boat. You see them sitting on the back of lots of motor yachts throughout the UK and Europe. And they build an excellent range. This is the baby of the range, so it's the smallest one they make. It fits into the tender garage of most sort of 50 footers. So if you're looking at putting something in a tender garage, around about 50 foot. The boat is a total length 3.29 meters. It's 1.7 meters wide. And I think it's around about 1.5 meters high as well from the bottom of the keel to the top of the console. I do know that I think you can remove the steering wheel to lower the height a wee bit, but it is a bit of a faff, I think. But this one has been used, certainly in the last, but the current owner has used it as like a standalone little sports boat because it is being sold complete with this little trailer. So it's an extreme road trailer, roller coaster trailer. So it's an absolute breeze to launch and recover the boat off the trailer. So you can actually use them as a standalone little sports boat. So we'll walk around it, show you the condition, and just point out anything it needs pointing out. But beautiful blue tubes. You've got these integrated handles down along both sides, three handles at either side. You have this nice big chunky rubbing strake, big PVC rubbing strake. So if you're tying up alongside the mothership or up alongside a pier wall or something, this protects the tubes. The tubes are in very good condition throughout. They're well adhered to the hull. There's nothing peeling, none of the patches are lifting or anything. Obviously this boat has only got 57 hours on it, so has seen very little use. The Williams badge, the end cones on the port side all look really good. So you can see the tubes slide up in there and the hull comes around to protect them. So let's have a look at the other side. There's not much to this boat, so I don't want to bang on for too long about it. But a couple of wee marks here in this rubbing strake, but obviously it's done its job of protecting the actual tube. And down along this side, tube also looks good. Hull bottom's good as well. Again, your handles here, some very slight little wear marks on the edges of the handles here, probably caused more by the cover sitting on top of it than anything else. Williams badge on this side is good. The rest of that rubbing strake looks well. End cone on the starboard side is good. And the bottom of the tubes there all looks nice and clean and tidy on this starboard side. The interior has the original Williams upholstery. So it's white upholstery with blue, navy blue piping. You've got the 325 badge there on the front of the console. You've got the Turbojet logo on the helm seat. So it's rated to carry a total of 4 adults plus 1 child up to a maximum combined weight of 338 kilos. So that's what the boat will hold, is 338 kilos. So decent weight capacity. The boat itself weighs 320 kilos. I know on the Shannon system, on the inland waterways here in Ireland, a lot of guys will like tow these boats, these little ribs behind their cruisers, or hang them off davits, which you can do with this boat because you've got your lifting eyes here in the floor. So you got, I think it's a total of 4 lifting eyes there. So you could easily hang the boat on a decent set of davits. So the weight of the boat is 319 kilos. So long as your davits are rated to carry sort of 320, that's dry. So there's also a 40 litre fuel tank. So you probably want davits rated for about 400 kilos, but if you've got davits that'll do that, you could easily hang this boat off the back of your inland cruiser. So plenty of seating, little bow seat up here, removable cushion, cushions are all in good condition. And underneath here is a little anchor locker. There's no anchor with it now, but room to store an anchor in there. You've got let me just get this back in again. We've got a little navigation nav light socket there, so for a wee pole light. I'm not sure, I'll have to have a look and see if the pole in the boat, but that's the socket for it. We have a nice little stainless steel cleat, so if you're tying up, you can use that to tie up at the forward end, and then you've got your bars there at the back. You can tie off with your ski tone eye or something. Then we have this little forward seat in front of the console. Now the upholstery in this, again, it's all original. It is starting to crack in a couple of spots. I just want to show you that. So let's get it removed here and I'll show you what I'm talking about. See just around the back corners there, just some starting to crack a little bit. It's not bad, but I mean, the purpose of these videos is to show you the condition of the boat, warts and all. So just want to show you that. Looks quite smart when it's on, but there's a wee bit of cracking on it. Bit of storage in there. Some minor little stress cracks in the corners. It's obviously just a manufacturing thing, but it's not structural. And then over on the other side, you've got your petrol filler cap. So you've got, as I said, a 40 litre built-in fuel tank. There's a wee key to unlock that. So you fill your fuel there, and if you spill any, you've got this nice little recessed area. It'll just drain down into the bilge or overboard or whatever, wherever that goes. But you're not going to be spilling fuel on the deck, which is nice. Then we've got our helm console and helm seat further aft. So your battery isolator switch is in underneath the helm seat. So you just turn that on through 90 degrees and then turn the ignition on, powers up the dash. Nice little comfortable helm seat, well padded on the sides. So it's like a wee bucket style seat, which is useful because this thing is seriously quick. For such a small boat, it's got 98 horsepower under the hood, so it goes like a rocket ship. Top speed on these is 50 miles an hour. And obviously being a jet drive, it'll turn on a sixpence. So you always want to make sure you're wearing your kill cord, number one. Number two, you want to be well wedged in there and hanging on tight if you are going to be chucking it around through the turns. Now, I fully intend to take this out in the water because I'm keen to have a run at it myself. But it's the weather at the minute is horrendous. We're shooting the video. This is the second week in January and the weather's atrocious, so it might be another few weeks before we get a chance to put it on the water and test it. It's also been winterized as well, so we don't want to dewinterize it just yet. But yeah, if you're buying it, of course we'll be able to arrange a sea trail, but there will be a sea trail video of this coming. It'll just be separate. So for now we're just doing the showroom tour. So always make sure you've got your lanyard attached whenever you're running this boat. Throttle and shift is here. It's all nice and smooth. You can do throttle only as well. Just need another hand to push that in. But controls are nice and smooth. One of the benefits and the beauties of jet drive is that all the controls are super smooth and the steering's only steering the wee bucket and stuff. So everything's really nice and easy to manage. Williams steering wheel, little carbon fiber effect on the center of the wheel. Nice small wheel. And then you've got your dash up here. So, sorry, I misspoke earlier. I thought I had 57 hours. It's actually only 53 hours. So my mistake, 53 hours. So this is your taco with built-in hour clock. Your fuel gauge is here. And you've got your speedo here with course over the grounds. That's your compass heading as well, with little digital compass heading. This is your navigation light switch. Again, we just need to check and make sure the pole is there. Bilge pump switch, that's working. You can hear that running. And the engine blower motor switch, now that's not working, so we will have to address that to fix the engine blower motor. And that's it, pretty simple. There's very little to it. Starting is just a matter of turning the key, and you can keep an eye. You've got a little engine warning lights over here, little warning light there. You know, so long as the lights, there's no warning lights on, you're good to go. So very easy little boat to drive. I think there's also a way of restricting the power output if you are training kids and things. I'll have to look into that, but the owner did say something about that. Got these nice fiberglass moldings around the transom to protect the tubes back here. We've got another little socket here, so that maybe that's a second location for the little navigation light. We have this as a flushing valve, so you can hook up a hose there to flush the engine with fresh water, which is really good, particularly if you're using the boat in the sea. Now, the reason that it's slightly removed at the minute is, you know, it's not sitting flush, is because it's currently blocked. So we have a new one of these coming for the boat. That's not working at the moment. The owner identified that at the end of the season. We've sort of disconnected the hose in behind it to flush it for now, but there is a new valve coming for that. So you'll be able to just push the hose on, start the engine, and it'll flush it with fresh water. You see all these scuppers, these drain scuppers in the bottom of all the moldings as well. It means that you can pull those out whenever the boat's underway. There's also one up forward here, just here. So you can just pop those out, and that means whenever the boat's running underway, any water that finds its way in there will drain overboard, and it comes out through these scupper points back here. So whenever the boat's on the plane, you can keep the deck drained. Just means if you're, you know, if there's any water comes on board, or if your people are swimming off the dinghy and there's water pulling in there, just pull the bungs, hit the throttle, and the water will drain out as you run the boat. A couple other wee things to point out back here are this lovely little stainless steel bathing ladder. So obviously, because this boat has such a powerful engine, there's bags of power for doing water sports with it. You know, you'll pull wakeboarders, water skiers, tubes, all that type of stuff, even with a full load of passengers in the boat. You know, if you've got three or four people in the boat, you still have plenty of power for water sports. And this little ladder means that it's a breeze to climb in and out of the boat. You've got your ski tow and eye here, so you attach your ski rope there and you fold the ladder down for getting in and out. You've got these big chunky stainless steel handrails as well. Obviously, being designed for the sort of super yacht industry, the fit and finish on this stuff is second to none. Really nice quality, high quality items, highly polished stainless steel, super solid as well. So it's going to look the part sitting on the back of your motor yacht. Let's take a look at the engine bay now. It's also very easy to access. Just pop off the clips. There's one on either side, and the whole helm console flips forward. That one's already off. So you just lift this up on a couple of gas struts. That stays up, and then you've got nice access around the engine. So as I said, it's a Weber motor, 750cc, makes 98 horsepower, which is a ton for this boat. There's your fuel tank down in there. So it's your 40 litre fuel tank. It almost looks bigger than 42 litres. It's stamped on it. There's a little plate down in there, but it's a 42 litre fuel tank. Little built-in fuel pump in the tank. Nice simple little engine. You've got this towing valve here, so you can close that off. If you're actually, what that means is if you're towing the boat behind the mothership, so to speak, it means that you won't get water work siphoning, back siphoning into the engine. So you can use that as well. And yeah, just a nice, simple little engine. It's only got 53 hours on it as well. So you wouldn't expect there to be much trouble with it. Everything looks nice and clean and tidy. There's not much in the way of service history with this boat, so probably is due a service. Now the owner was saying could do with a bit of a service, but starting on the button anyway. And as I said, we're going to water test it before the boat leaves here. So there you go, that is the engine bay. It all looks nice and clean and tidy down in there. While we're looking at that, let's take a quick look at the jet drive out the back. So you've obviously got your bucket here for reversing, you've got your nozzle here that steers. I think I might have said the bucket steers earlier, doesn't it? It's the nozzle, just this bit that you use for steering, and this is for reversing. It's some anodes down in here, which are in perfect condition. The exhaust outlet is nice and clean and tidy there. And the plate and everything looks good. The water pickup points look good. And the hull bottom looks to be in good shape as well. Let's take a wee quick look along the hull bottom actually. The original gel coat finish, obviously, never been anti-foiled. It all looks really nice, actually. Just looking to see if there's any sort of previous repairs or anything, but nothing there that I can really see. You might be able to see better on the camera than I can see here just we're giving the angle, that's that, but yeah, neat and tidy. So that's it. That's about all there is to show you on this little Turbojet 325. Two other quick things to point out. This seat cushion lifts up. It's also in nice condition. All the wee button poppers are all there. Then there's, this is a like a another wee maintenance patch or something. Whatever you're supposed to get at down in there, but that's all there and working as it should. And finally, I have talked an awful lot about this navigation pole light on this boat. I would presume that those little clips up there are where it's supposed to live, and it's not there. So I'll check with the owner to see whether he has that at home, but you may have to replace the wee nav pole light. It's not a big deal. If you're not planning on boating at night time in this little rib tender, then you won't need it. But if you are at night time, you are supposed to show an all-round white light. So just want to point that out so that, you know, you're not wondering if there's a nav light with it. It comes complete with this little Williams fitted tonneau cover as well. So it's the original factory tonneau cover, custom made for the boat. Great little cover, actually. You can throw it on in a matter of seconds. It has the Williams logo on both sides. It has these little straps so you can tie it down onto the trailer or just tie it down underneath the boat if you need to. It has this drawstring. You just pull it around, clips tight, and you can pull it tight. Well-fitted cover. And then it also has these little eyelets in the top so you can tie those up. And that, you know, works like a tent then, so the water runs off. So yeah, super, super easy cover to work with. Throw it on in no time at all, and it keeps the elements off the tubes and the interior of the boat. So that's all going with it as well. So that is our 2010 Williams Turbojet 325. It's a lovely little boat. It's only got 53 hours on the clock. And it's not perfect, but it's pretty damn close for a 2010. It's on a very good little trailer. The trailer's super solid. I didn't really talk much about the trailer, but a very good little trailer. Wheel bearings and stuff are all perfect. It obviously has the cover that we've seen. And yeah, only 53 hours on the clock. A couple of wee minor things maybe to address, but I think it's well priced. They're a very popular little boat. As I said, either for, as a tender for your bigger motor cruiser or as a standalone sports boat. And if you are interested, stay tuned. Keep an eye on our YouTube channel or the website, and there will be a sea trial video coming in the near future, hopefully in the next 3 or 4 weeks, before the end of the month if we can manage it. So thank you very much for taking the time to watch this video. I hope you found it useful. If you have any questions about the boat, if you want to arrange to come and see it, or if you want to talk to me about making an offer or arranging logistics to get it transported to your home marina, then please don't hesitate to get in touch. The best way to do that is by giving me a call on the number at the top of our website, or you can send me an email to sales@gulfstreamshop.com, or you can fill out the callback request form on this page of our site, and I'll contact you at a time that's convenient. Thank you very much for taking the time to watch the video. I hope you found it useful.